Welcome back everyone. An approach for problem C, quiz system tournament of Add Coder Beginners Contest 2022 will be discussed. So stay tuned till the end to have a look at an approach. So before beginning, let us have a look at the problem statement. We have been given 2n players with ID from 1 to 2n and they participate in rock scissor paper contest. So there will be m rounds and 1 to 1 matches will be there. Only each player can play against another player at most one time. So has to play one time. And a constraint is given for this problem statement that for each match from 1 to n, the player plays or the player whose rank is 2k minus 1 and k at the end of the i minus 1 round plays 2. So here this statement means that suppose player is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on till 2k minus 1 and 2k. So here player 1 will play against player 2 in the first round because initially the rank of the player, all the players are 0, and 3 will play against 4 and so on. So this is for the round 1. So this is for round 1. And based on this, some rankings will be assigned to players, like whoever wins will be given some rank. Or so to know more about this, let us proceed further. So in each round there will be total n matches. So total games that will be played are m cross n. M rounds and each round n matches will be there. Total m into n games will be played. And so let us proceed further. In each match, two players play a hand just once, resulting. So either a player can win or lose, or can be a draw. So draw can happen only if the both the players make same decision or take the same decision. Now a Takashi has been given and what he needs to find is the rank of the player at the mth round, end of mth round. So in case anyone doesn't know about the rules of rock, paper and scissor, the problem setters have given that. So here the cases are if player 1 or player I chooses rock and player I plus 1 chooses C, then the player rock wins. So three outcomes are possible, and in case the player plays the same and the match is drawn, as I have already said, mentioned. And one more constraint is given: in case of ranking of player, ties are broken by ID numbers. A player with smaller ID gets the higher rank. And So the ranking is calculated based on the number of wins. So the more the number of wins, higher will be the rank. And if the matches are, there are draws, or if there are draws, that can be broken with the smaller IDs. And also if the number of wins of player I and I plus 1 or any player is same, then in that case also this is broken. Okay, so this just seems an implementation type of problem here, because all the rules are given, we just need to map all these rules and look at the constraint and then get the outcome or output. So let us say that there are total of three players, P1, P2, and P3. So and here the scorecard can be represented as so win, lose, and draw. So these are the possible, and the ranks, I would rank. So here player 1, player 2, player 3. So as given in the question is that P1 plays with P2. So P3 is left, but that is not possible because the number of players has to be even. So P4 also plays. So how many rounds will be there? 4. Oh, sorry. 2 into. So M has to be decided by us. So let's suppose M is 2. So I think 4 matches will be played, 2 rounds. So here 4 matches will be played. So first is between P1, P2 and P3, P4. So P1 wins if he takes, if he plays rock and player 2 plays scissor. So here rock will win. So here player 1 wins. So player 1 wins against player 2. And player 3 draws against player 4. So this is one possible outcome. So here the outcome can be G, C. So G will be the winner. So for round 1 and G, G, here draw. So I not mention anything. And in round 2, so in round 2, let us assume that the player, now the ranking is P1 is at the first position, P2 loses, so it is at the fourth position, and in case of tie, the player with the smaller ID wins, so player 2 and 3. So this is the ranking as per round 1. Now as per round 2, let us suppose that the player 1 has to play against player 3 and player 2 has to play against player 4. So let us suppose P1 draws with P3. So here draw, here draw, sorry, here draw. And P2 wins against P4. So the ranking of the player here can be CC, or here paper, here again GC. Let us assume GC. So these are the four strings, and the rankings after round 2 will be, then player 1 and player 2 has 1-1 win. So and P1 has drawn, so P1 will still lead because of the lower ID. Then P2, now in case of a draw, here score is not mentioned. If suppose P1, if draws happen, so what can be the score? So let's suppose 0.5. So here 1.5 and 1, and P3 is at 1 and P4 is at 0.5. So as per this, if the assumption here is that for win there will be 1 point, for loss 0 point, and for draw 0.5. If based on this assumption, if an assumption is made that a score is created in this form, which is not mentioned in the question, but we don't require that. So here the score will be 1.5, 1, 1, and then 0.5. So the ranking at the end of round 2 will be P1 followed by P2 followed by P3 followed by P4. This scoring is not mentioned in the question. Here the assumption is made that this can happen, or this should have happened. So this is ranking. Now we need to find the player's rank. So the player's rank are 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is for this test case, how the game should proceed. Now let us have a look at the code. So here what I have done is I have taken N and M and a string of arrays. Why string of arrays? Because if you look at this, like GG, so this is one string, this is another string, a CC, then PP, and let GC. So this would be a string of four arrays, string of four arrays. So and if you are trying to use character, then it will become two dimensional array. So character of string of here 4, two, sorry, we have four rows and two columns, so it will be like this. So here S would be, if you are trying to implement using character, then this will be 2 into n followed by n. So here I have taken string of arrays of size 2n, and then I have taken pair or in the form of vector array. So the pair first int value is for the ranking of players, and second int is for choosing the player, which player plays against which player based on the rank. So for choosing which player plays, second int is used, and it is also of size 2n. Then I have taken input, and now, so in the first loop is for the contest. There will be m rounds, and in each round there will be n games. So here now how the games will proceed. So here I have taken x, which will be between player I 2k minus 1, and y is player 2k, and then the character c is chosen to know that what is the rank. So if I choose C, so that will represent the rank of player 2J or 2K minus 1. And if I choose player D, then I would know what is their rank at the end of the IAT contest. So as per the rules, so in case player 1 has rock, and then so rules are followed, and then since the match between those two players has already happened, then we decrease the, or we change the scorecard, or we update the values, and then, or we proceed to the next round to have a look at that this player has already played. Now the pairings will be based on the rank. So this player has to play, ith player has to play against I plus some k value based on the rank. So for that I am trying to check that whether this match has all, because everyone has to play one game, at most one game. So either it can play with them or they may not, based on the M rounds. No, everyone has to play every game in M rounds. So like in first round, P1 plays against P2 and P3 plays against P4. So when P1, P2 plays, so I will mark here that P1, P2 has played, and then I will assign rank. So similarly, I will assign for player 1 as well as player 2. Then I will proceed for player 3 and player 4. So in that way, ranks will be assigned, whether they have chosen this option based on the three options available, which of the option player choose, based on that ranks will be assigned. And once, so this will be after round 1, then since rank is of array 2n, I will know that this player has already played. Now proceed to next player, and then I will look at the array and check which player is yet to play against the ith player. So in that way I will keep I will make sure that all the player plays in the mth round, till the mth round. So once I have done, I have written the ranks. Now I'm sorting those ranks. Why? Because I have to rank those player from the highest to lowest as given in the question. So in each round I will update the ranks and then I will print the ranking of those player. So this is the code explanation. Now let us have a look at the time and space complexity for this problem. So time complexity will be order of m into n for comparison of for assigning ranks. And then for sorting, here it will be 2n into log of 2n base 2. So here the complexity is considered in terms of big O notation, log of n. Here using quicksort based on the sort function. So this is for sorting ranks. So the time complexity for this problem is order of m into n plus n log n. And the space complexity for this problem will be order of m into n. I am ignoring the constant 2. So this will be used for assigning rank. Assigning rank, an additional array of size m2n into n is used. So in worst case, m can be equal to n, worst case. So this will become order of n square in worst case.